Hello, and thank you for joining me for another 2-minute tutorial, the place where we provide tips and tricks in just 120 seconds. This time we're going to be looking at Outlook's scheduling assistant. Don't you find it really annoying when somebody pops in a meeting into your diary right over the top of another meeting, and then you've got to decline the meeting, propose a new time, and all that palaver? Yeah, I know you find it frustrating. Well, Scheduling Assistant really helps with dealing with that problem from the very outset. So let's see if we can beat the clock today. Shall we do it, Bruno?
As you can see, I have my Outlook already open. I have got a random point in the future that I'd like to book a meeting in, so we'll double click on a date. And you see we've got our new window opened up. So let's pop in the name for this meeting. It's 2-minute tutorial. And we're gonna make it a Teams meeting. So that will click on that and that will put in all the details in there. Now the main thing we're here for is Scheduling Assistant. So we have Scheduling Assistant here. Let's pop in somebody that we're going to test against. And what this does is, on a linear form, gives you your calendar and that person's calendar. So you can kind of look and find free time within the day. The more people there are, the tougher it becomes. But at least you're giving you're putting your best foot forward when looking for that free time in a meeting. You can also select your rooms. You can either select it from here and search for it, or you can do here up at the top, add rooms. For instance, I've got the boardroom and desk one because we are hot desking. Double click those, add them to the rooms, hit OK, and they'll pop up over here. And that'll give you the availability for those bits. If you don't want them to be part of the booking, just uncheck them over here, or you can delete them back in the meeting section. So you can just click there and delete away. And here I've set the meeting to be 1 hour. You can increase that time for as many hours as you like. As you notice, there's a little glitch there. And up here you can see it says this appointment conflicts with another one on your calendar. If you pop back to the Scheduling Assistant, you can see it hits over meetings that we've already got acquired. And that'll happen with anybody else that you've added into that meeting. Really useful if when you are setting a meeting, you look into calendars and look at people's time so that you're not just looking at your own availability and you have a higher rate of everyone accepting the meeting instead of having to do all the faff of trying to fit in time or ask questions of, are you available here? This works brilliantly in for internal. External, you have to work a little bit harder. And that is Scheduling Assistant.